Are the Yankees further away from the Red Sox than we thought?
They are not further away from the Red Sox as long as they clean up a few key things. I'm not a big proponent of, you know, completely blowing this thing up as you hear, you know, certain things. I certainly don't think that's going to happen. That being said, we saw in Game 1 of the World Series what a shaky defense does to a team. I thought the Dodgers, you know, if not for their defensive lapses in Game 1, could have won that game and stole Game 1 at Fenway.
Yep.
But defensively, the Yankees are not where they need to be. When you have Miguel Andujar, who is arguably one of your top three hitters, might win the Rookie of the Year, and he's not playing Game 4 against the Red Sox because they're worried about his defense, that is a problem. You cannot have your key players be defensive liabilities. And whether you're talking about Andujar, whether you're talking about Gary Sanchez, whoever's going to play first base, we have some holes on the Yankees roster defensively that need to get shored up. And I think Brian Cashman, I praise Cash up and down the line. He's going to figure it out this offseason to make a few tweaks here and there to shore up his defense, but also keep that kind of potent lineup out there.
Now, we were talking earlier in the week about the Yankees changing their approach. Stop with the whole launch angle and the exit velocity and try to be more situational. If they make that type of a commitment, can you make the players you have change their approach, or do you have to go find players that can do that?
I think you can do a little bit of both. I think you can look at a guy like Aaron Judge, who at times will shorten his swing up and you know, take that single to right or not try to launch. I think J.D. Martinez does a great job of it as well. I mean, he doesn't always have to launch, but if his team needs a big three-run homer, he can do that as well. If you have guys like Giancarlo Stanton that can do that as well, now your middle of your lineup has two guys that not only have 50 home run potential, but in the big situations, they can drive in the runs. I think the biggest thing is the Yankees have to get better with runners in scoring position. And so whatever you need to do as an individual to get better, Marcus Thames and the entire coaching staff is going to work this spring training and during next season to fix it. It's small tweaks, and I think the Yankees can get there without having to completely revamp their lineup.
I'm just acting as the middleman here, Mark. Rick DiPietro from our station, former first pick in the NHL draft, all-around good guy. He plays in a hardball league once a week. And he just said, please ask Mark if he's available to DH next week. I will include flight and playoff bonuses.
Unfortunately, I'm not available. I'm playing in a golf tournament as soon as the World Series is over. I'm going to have to miss that this year. But tell Rick, thank you for the invitation.
Think about it, though. If you could do it, could you get out there and just rake?
In a men's
hardball league,
Men's hardball league?
Yeah, they throw like 88 miles an hour.
If I can't, I got issues. I got some serious issues if I can't get a few hits in that league.
Love it.